Hello friends, welcome back to the Python programming session. In the earlier session, we have started with inheritance. We saw all the different types of inheritance in Python programming language. And in today's session, let's look into some of the code examples for the different types of inheritance. In today's session, let's cover for single inheritance and multiple inheritance, the code examples for these two inheritance. So firstly, for single inheritance, so we know for single inheritance there is one base class and one derived class. And the derived class inherits the properties of the base class. So, single means one. So, there is one base class and one derived class. And the derived class inherits the properties of the base class. For this, now let's look into an example, code example for single inheritance. Suppose I have class parent as the base class. Parent is the base class. Now let me define a function called show p, and self is the first parameter in the method because it is an instance method, so we are passing self as the first parameter. And within the method, let me say print I am Sam's parent. So I am having one class called parent, and I am having a method inside the class which prints the statement I am Sam's parent. Now let me go in for the derived class. So class child inherits the properties of the parent. So, we have to pass the parent class as a parameter within parenthesis of the derived class. So, we have to mention it as class child within parenthesis. We have to pass the parameter parent so that we come to know that it is inheriting the properties of the parent class. And now, let me have my method show c for child and self, and let me print I am Sam. So this class, only when we create an object it will be instantiated. So let's create an object called obj equal to child. When I create an object for the child, then I can access the methods in the child class and the parent class. But when I create an object for the parent, I can access only the parent method. I cannot access the child method. So now if I say obj.showP and again obj.showC. So when I do this, I can access the method in parent class and I can access the method in the child class. Now when I print this statement, print obj.showP and print, sorry, if I just call this statement, it will get printed because we are having the print statement within the function. So when I call obj.showP, it will print on the console, it will print I am Sam's parent. And if I give obj.showC, this particular method will be called and it will print I am Sam on the console. So, the child can access the methods of parent as well as the child. because it is inheriting the properties of the parent, while the parent class cannot access the methods in the child class. So this is how it works in Python. So this is how single inheritance works in Python. Now let's go into multiple inheritance. Multiple inheritance. In multiple inheritance, we have more than one base class. I'm taking two classes as in this example, but we can have more than two classes, two or n number of classes, base classes we can have. So this is base 1 and this is base 2. And the derived class inherits the properties of both these classes. Derived class accesses the property, inherits the properties of base 1 and base 2. We can have n number of base classes, and the derived class will inherit from n number of base classes as well. In this example, I am considering only two base classes. So the code example for this would be class father, and then let me have a method within the father class, show f DEF, and then print I am father of Sam. So in the class father, they are having one method which is the show F, and it prints I am father of Sam. Now let me have another base class. This is a base class. Father is a base class. Let me have mother as another base class. And let me say DEF show M. Sorry, this is self, not DEF. Self. And let me have my print statement. I am mother of Sam. So these two are the base classes. They are not inheriting any other class. So these two are the base classes. Now let me write the derived class or the child class as child, and it inherits the properties of parent, father and mother. So in parenthesis, we have to write the two classes from which it inherits, that is father and then mother. So the child class inherits the properties of the father class and the mother class. Now let me say my def show C self, and let me print I am Sam. I am Sam. So in this case, we have multiple, more than one base classes, and the child class is inheriting from more than one base class. So these base classes are separated by a comma and passed as a parameter to the child class. And so the child class can now access the methods of father, mother and child. So when we create an object obj equal to child, and if we say obj dot show f, obj dot show m, obj dot show c. So when it can access the methods in father, mother and child, while the father class can access only show F and the mother class can access only show M, while the child class can access show F, show M and show. So when I give this particular statement, it will print, I am father of Sam. Show M will print, I am mother of Sam. And show C prints, I am Sam. So you can access all the methods in the parent as well as its own class. So this is the code example for multiple inheritance. Hope so friends, it is clear for you. The code examples of single inheritance and multiple inheritance. In the next class, let's see multi-level and hierarchical inheritance. If you have any doubts, please do reach to me out in the comment section. If you like my video, click on the like button and please do subscribe to get notifications of my new videos. Till then, see you. Bye-bye.